If there is anyone here today who feels that their father has not blessed them or expressed love or acceptance to them, I cannot change that human relationship, but I can tell you that your Father in heaven reaches out even now and puts his hand on your head and says to you, I am your heavenly Father. I love you. I accept you. I am proud of you. I bless you. We are all blessed. In the Old Testament, the laying on of hands turns up again and again. One of the funny places it happens is that the people were instructed to confess their sins to the priest. And then by confessing, they would transmit their sins into the priest. But then you can't have the priest walking around full of all this sin. So God told the priest then to go and lay his hand on the head of a goat. And to say then to the goat, I transmit the sins of the people into you. Poor goat. And then the priest would sacrifice that goat, and when the goat died, the sins of the people would die and be forgiven also. Now that, of course, is the scapegoat. In the story of Joshua leading the people into the promised land, we know that Joshua could not do that until Moses, who had been the leader of the people up to that point, put his hand on Joshua's head in the midst of all the people, and he said to Joshua, by the power of God, I now transmit my spirit and my authority to you. I now cease to be leader. You are the leader of the children of Israel. So in the Old Testament, the laying on of hands means that power is transmitted from one person to another. It's really significant. In the New Testament, Jesus refines the notion of the laying on of hands. And if you'll note, when Christ uses the laying on of hands, it shows you what his ministry is all about. Christ lays hands on a specific group of people. He touches the sick, the sinful, and the outcast. And of course, the religion of his age specifically forbid touching sinners or outcasts, because they said God had punished those people, that's why they were sick. So if you touched them, you also would become unclean. And Jesus, of course, said that is nonsense. My Father wants his loving spirit to be transmitted to those who are broken and sick and poor and outcast. And so in so many of his stories, you see, they begin by saying, and he touched, or he laid his hands, or he touched the eyes of the blind man. And again, he's going back to that Old Testament idea that in the touch, there is the transmitting of the Holy Spirit. And what Jesus was saying to the sick and the sinners and the outcasts who had all been condemned by the church was this. God accepts you. God is proud of you. God blesses you. In a like manner, when they brought the children to Jesus that he should bless them, the notion of blessing children would have seemed ridiculous to the church, because children didn't count as human beings. So the disciples drove the children away, but Jesus said, suffer the little children to come unto me, for of such is the kingdom of heaven, and you shall not enter the kingdom unless you enter as a little child. And he placed his hands on them, and he blessed them. And when he did that, it was a shocking and amazing thing that a priest would say to anybody, God blesses these little children. The power of the Spirit flowed, which is the power. power of love and acceptance and grace. We read that wonderful passage in Acts 8 this morning, where in Samaria, the people have seen the power of the Spirit, which is the power of love and grace. And one of the people in Samaria, Simon the magician, saw this, and he went to the disciples and he took out his wallet and he started peeling back the shekels and he said, "How much do you want? I will pay you anything if you give me the power to touch and transmit the Spirit." And the response, of course, is one of the greatest lines in all of Scripture. The response was, "You and your money can go to hell." And if you've ever known anybody who thought they could buy something with their money that wasn't for sale, I now give you all my permission to say to them, "You and your money can go to hell." As long as you then quote Acts 8, verse 20. It's not a power that you can buy. In the 21st century, it's a beautiful thing. It leads us back into before the dawn of humankind, and it gives us a sense of how significant it is because we've been doing it for so long. In the laying on of hands, we are saying, "We the people accept you. We bless you. We love you. We believe that God's power is with you. We see God's Spirit within you. We accept you as our leaders and people to build us up in faith." And all of you must know, God has put his hand on each one of you, and God has ordained all of you to some special ministry only you can do. And I pray you will feel God's power and blessing and engage in your ministry with joy from this day forward. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.